Wait, Witcher! When you find my daughter, will you give her this?
A ragdoll?
Uh-huh.
I don't remember that. I don't remember. What?
Went to the village for the levy. And that one.
Doll!
The lass. To the bloody baron and ripped him a new one.
Where'd you say you heard this? Ever heard of preventive arse whooping?
What the fuck?
Gee,
bring the Smiths, lass. Gap toothed one.
Not a bad idea. Nice tits on her.
I'm talking about the shrieker.
Fair look, make sure I'm actually not overstepping my bounds quest wise here. What level am I? Oh, yeah, I'm good.
What's that you're muttering?
Remember ever being handled a doll before in the other ones. And like in any other two playthroughs I did. So I'm really confused as to what the fuck that's even gonna mean. Like, I do not remember getting a doll from him when going to find his daughter. Directly fast travel there yet, so where's the closest I can get? You'll have to do it. Understand.
Prince, full moon soon. Bar your windows tilt, and I will an iron stud in the doorframe. If only I had milk to leave at the doorstep, that'd be sure to keep the demons away.
Halt! No passage.
Case of the plague surface in the city or something?
The plague? No.
we're to not let folk in the city. It's an order, so I don't, unless someone's got a pass.
This way, you mean?
Let me look at that. Missing a seal, the red one.
Impossible.
Department of Civil Defense forgot again. They're really off their heads these days. Happens, so be it. You may come through.
Steve, come through. Redania. Sod off.
As to the why I have this doll. I am also confused by it.
Ain't of the Kingfisher, you're sorted for at least 2 days. I just got a judgment. What can I get you, sir? Have everything from apples to cider.
Look at a peek at my wares.
Oh, I'm out, sir. A requisition by the hour to support the war.
Hey, war.
You'll choke to death on 3 pounds of steel.
I'm looking for Tamara, the Bloody Baron's daughter. Your brother said I'd find her here.
Wojtek sent you, sir.
How else would I know she was here?
Wait a moment. I'll fetch her straight away.
You're looking for me, and who might you be? My father send you?
Yeah, to see if you're still alive. And well. I'm Geralt of Rivia.
I'm quite alive and extraordinarily well, Geralt of Rivia. Better than I've ever been in this rotten life of mine, and now that you've seen me, I bid you farewell.
Wait.
We've nothing more to talk about.
Got every right to be angry at your father, but he's worried about you.
I have a right. Thank you kindly. So good to have the approval of his hired thug. And my father worries only about what to get soused on next.
He's no saint, that's clear. But he's got the whole province on its feet looking for you. Finding you and your mother? Seems to me there's nothing more important to him now. I know evil men. He's not one of them.
Shame he never showed such concern before. Especially for my mother.
He made a mistake and knows that. I'm not defending him, just saying that maybe he's come to realize what he's done and what you mean to him.
Oh, wonderful. I'll bear that in mind. Did you really come all the way here just to tell me that?
Before I agreed to look for you, your father told me his version of events. Tell me yours.
Mine? It's dull as life amidst the swamps. My earliest memories are of a drunken father lying under the stairs, caked in mud and clutching a bottle. Next dozen years, pretty much the same. Father would drink, disappear for days, then come home in a rage and send furniture flying. Thank the gods for war. I was glad every time they sent him off. And the quarrels. I remember him screaming at Mum, the thuds as he beat her, then her sobbing. I'd hide under my bed and long for silence. That's the long and short of it. Multiply by 19, and there you have my life. Finally, we'd had enough, Mum and me. He crossed the line and we fled.
Wojtek claims your mother had strange marks on her hands, and that a monster dragged her into the woods. That true?
We were riding towards the river. Suddenly, Mum cried out, bent over, almost fell off her horse. I rode up to her and saw something strange. Her hands were on fire. And then that creature leapt from the woods. I don't know what it was, but it roared so fierce my nose bled. I saw it topple trees. I've never been so scared in my life.
That thing grabbed my mum and disappeared into the woods. I wanted to turn back, go after them, but the horses panicked. Now I don't even know if she's alive.
I don't mean to pry, but I know your mother had a miscarriage.
His doing? He shoved her, she fell, that's how it started. We were alone, no one to help, blood everywhere. Worst night of my life.
Sorry. Must have been hard for you both.
Mum was in shock. She was raving that it was better this way, that she never wanted the charge. Must have had a fever. She was losing blood the whole time.
She didn't want the child?
Said she'd sooner cut open her gut than bear another child from his seed.
Hmm.
What will you do now?
Find my mum.
You realize that might not be that easy.
Don't worry, I'm not daft enough to believe I can do it alone. I've got some new friends now. Powerful friends. They'll help me.
What about your father?
Who? Oh, him. I don't care. I won't go back to him. That bit of my life? Forgotten it already.
Who are these friends, if it's not a secret?
No secret. Heard of the Church of the Eternal Fire? A priest helped me contact the Redanian witch hunters. Righteous, brave men. They'll help me.
Hence the candlesticks in your room. So you believe in the Eternal Fire?
Once the heat of the fire has set your heart aflame, it gives you strength and leads you down the path of truth for the rest of your life. I hope it'll bless you with its warmth one day.
Thanks. Thing is, fire's tricky. It's easy to get burned.
Well, well. A witcher. Never thought the Baron would stoop to hiring a monster slayer. Though I hear you're good at tracking things down.
Glad you know who I am. Haven't introduced yourself, though.
Gradin. Witch hunter in the service of His Royal Majesty Radovid of Redania. I'm certain you've heard of us.
Rings a bell.
If the Bloody Baron sent you to fetch his daughter, you'd best face it. You will fail in your task.
I appreciate your concern, but I don't need it. As for Tamora, she can make her own decisions.
Noble of you. A killer for hire, abandoning his bounty for the good of another. The hunters and the Church of the Eternal Fire thank you. So the Baron hired a witcher to find his daughter. Interesting.
Desperate fathers have been known to do a lot to find their daughters.
Unexpected from a witcher. I thought your mutations cleansed you of humanity. Stripped you of emotions.
You don't need mutations to strip men of their humanity. I've seen plenty of examples. Where are you going to take her?
Tamora must rest. She's had a harrowing experience. When the warmth of the Eternal Fire has restored her strength, we shall see about finding her mother.
Before you go, your father asked me to give you this.
Clara? Father told you to give me Clara. Funny how he thought to buy me back with a memory. Tell him one gesture could never make up for a ruined childhood. So long, Witcher. In spite of all, I'm grateful you gave me a choice. Didn't force me to go back to the tyrant.
Hope you know what you're getting yourself into. So long, and good luck.
Well, that changed nothing. One piece. I must have fixed it the last time I went to I went to the town. Yeah, it's all perfectly fixed. Alright, that tells me I just fixed it the last time I was in town, so I didn't worry about that, right? Just a moment. Not where I was meant to be. As soon as I find a signpost, I don't remember where the beach one is.
Ow! What's
moving on? There is a signpost.
What the devil?
Back, talk to the Baron. I wish I could spawn closer in. It would be kind of nice. But I can't.
I'm listening. What do you come to me with?
Gave Tamara your gift.
How'd she react?
Probably not like you'd have wanted. She threw the doll away.
Threw it away? Gods, I hoped, despite all. But what of Anna?
Still don't know anything specific, but I'm on her trail.
Well, will you stand there like a knob? Find her!
Oh man, you're so fucking grateful.
Frick. So long.
Let's see, what have we got? Leaves of the Wood, yep, that I gotta do.
This be the Witchman, the freak of nature.
Oh, read the Ladies of the Wood. Okay, so I gotta read a book first. I already pick it up and got it somewhere. This is safe conduct. There, it's been read.
Got a lump of bread today.
really getting any closer to the fog by the look of things. Right, this dick.
Halt! Standing Jew! I challenge you!
Boots a bit big, maybe? Careful not to trip.
Halt, I say! I am Rondvid of the Small Marsh, bound by a sacred oath.
Oh, that's rough. My sympathies.
To honor Maid Bilberry, fairest of all maids I know, by dueling 100 knights to the death. Now, draw your sword post-haste, for I've knights in hand left after you.
Why are you challenging me? Don't recall doing anything to offend the Maid Bilberry.
Well, why? Then swear. Swear! Maid Bilberry's the most loveliest of all.
Thing is, I've never laid eyes on her.
Aha! I shall wash your scorn away with thy blood fiend. Stand and fight!
No! I yield!
Had enough?
Yes. Looks good with you. But the next time we meet...
Go back to Maid Bilberry and apologize for being an ass. Quick, before I change my mind and break your bones.
We shall meet again.
Come on.
Off the horse. Get off the horse. Remember how to get off the horse. Yeah, they killed him. Damn. No, what's in the other one? Use this junk. Meditate for an hour rather than use potions.
Faster.
Forced to get off. What did I run through that's now only triggering?
Look, we got ourselves a
customer.
Oh, God.
Not about to buy anything from you.
Oh, afraid you're mistaken. If we're to let you pass, you gotta pay.
And if I don't?
Then you die.
See this medallion?
Gaffer! Gaffer!
Shut it, Solbeck. Aye. Now I see it. We didn't mean no...
Recognize the guild?
Aye, master. Forgive us for not remarking on it earlier. Please.
Gaffer! Gaffer!
Now listen. Might pass through again someday. Don't know when. But when I do, I don't want to run into you. That clear?
As a summer's day, my lord. Godspeed you on your path.
Now you guys better fuck off.
Gaffer,
was it now, Solbeck?
Gaffer, he's a witcher.
Solbeck. What? Shut. See, I'm really confused by it trying to take the route that it wants me to take. Oh, that's why. I'm going to hit a fucking dead end here soon. Whoopsies. There's a boat to my left. Huh. Just how close can I get? I can get pretty close. Yep. keep forgetting I need to go through and get ingredients for potions at some point.
Doug went in the kitchen, stole a hunk of meat. Cook gave him a licking, strung him by his feet.
Cooked them blood and empty, stripped his skin off clean. Laughed and said how tasty, best sausage I have seen.
Cook's a stupid killer, shouldn't have ate the pup. Now we light a fire, gonna roast him up. 1, 2, 3, the one to fetch the kindlings, thee!
Interesting rhyme.
Don't know you. Go away.
What are you doing out here alone?
We's not alone. We's with Gran.
But where did you all come from?
We's orphans.
All of you?
There's a war, so there's orphans. Didn't know that.
I'm looking for the witches of Crookback Bog.
You look like a witch yourself. The witches of the bog. We can't go in the bog. Gran didn't let us.
When my brother Zemek went missing, Gran said it was because he went in the woods and got lost. Gran cried an awful lot after that.
He could still come back.
A young woman got lost in the swamp. She has ashen hair and a scar on her face. You kids see anyone like that?
Ain't no lassie's here. What am I?
You're no lassie. Lassie's got tits.
They do. Heard an old man say once, when the army was here, he says, hide them lassies in the woods. They's dazzling the soldiers with their tits. And it's torturing the poor lads. That's what he said.
Anyone else here, besides you?
Meaning who?
Someone who might have seen the woman.
Like the six-eyed tree?
Tree slapped all year. But there is Johnny.
What's this talk? What kind of jabbering is this, eh? No one allowed here. Just kids. My kids. They're allowed. But who are you, wearing swords like a bandit?
You look after these kids?
They're my grandchildren.
Gran's good to us. Gonna be soup with scratchings for supper.
Kids get lost in the woods. I miss them. Seen them in the woods? No one has.
Just talking to the kids. Asked them if they'd seen a young woman.
Oh, I was a lovely young woman. Wore a long, beautiful braid my mummy did up for me. Had dresses with flowers on them.
Maybe you've seen her. Young, ashen hair.
Your betrothed?
Daughter, actually.
Daughter? My dear, sweet little daughter and her sister. Where are they now? Maybe they've come to some harm?
A bit of help, please. A young, ashen-haired woman. Just need to know if you've seen her.
What are you looking at, children? Wash your hands, we'll go catch crickets.
Won't learn anything from you.
Aye, because I don't know nothing.
That Johnny knows. He knows a lot. When I ask him something, he says, wait, I'll scratch my arse and tell you.
Ugly word. What you saying? To the hut.
You'll stand in a corner. I'll make sure you do.
You! Be gone! Be gone! Can't come in here. Not allowed in here.
I just want to talk to the boy.
Not allowed. It's not allowed.
He won't talk to you anyway. Gran don't like you. And Johnny's made up. And stranger still, kids.
Just got one question for you.
Don't be asking no questions. You're a stranger. Not allowed to talk to strangers.
Can we eat now? Suit with scratchings.
You here? Says he's afeard of you. Stop scaring my kids.
Why don't you want to talk about Johnny? One of you knows about him. The others must too.
It's just him who's pals with Johnny. They pick mushrooms and hunt snails. But Gran says Johnny's made up.
Have any of you ever seen Johnny?
Of course. Looks just like him.
Then why do you say he's made up?
Gran says so. And Gran knows lots.
Does your Gran treat you right? She ever hurt you?
Never.
When we're bad, she cries.
She's scared. Says strangers might take us. And we'll disappear.
The boy who plays with Johnny, he must be brave.
Not brave, just stupid.
Sat his bare bum on an anthill once. But yeah, he plays with Johnny. He don't listen to Gran and goes in the woods, and then he's got to have a time out.
And eat snails. Yuck.
The girl I mentioned is in danger. You gotta help me get your Gran away from the hut so I can talk to Johnny's friend.
All right, but you gotta do something for us too. Play hide and seek. Gran never does. Says her feet hurt.
Let's play. You hide, but if I find you, you have to help me talk to the boy who knows Johnny.
He thinks he'll find us easy.
Means he's never hid from the black ones.
No looking, and you have to count out loud. All your fingers, toes, too.
One, two, three, 18. 19, 20. Ready or not, here I come. I can see you. Aww. See you. Come out. Found you. You can stop hiding.
How'd you find me?
No one left hiding.
You're a wizard, right? Gonna show us some tricks when we get to the cottage.
No, we'll talk about your promise. Found you all. Now you gotta keep your word and help me talk to Johnny's friend.
Why wouldn't we? Promised, didn't we?
Don't be afraid.
Don't know nothing.
I won't hurt you.
Where's Gran?
She's busy. Why are you scared to talk?
I'm not scared of nothing.
You're all scared of something. Would have told me about Johnny otherwise.
I'm worried about Johnny. He don't come around no more. Once, when we was mushroom picking, I saw his burrow. But Gran yelled at me. Said not to talk to strangers, cause then kids go missing. She worries about Johnny too, though she says he's made up.
Where are you and your friend's parents?
Dad, some starved. Others were killed. Like mine. One day, he went out at dawn to look for berries in the woods. Still some around back then. When I was coming home, I heard the yells. Then, laughing, went up and hid in the bushes near the woods. My mum yelled, and the soldiers laughed. Levi parked out by the barn door. His head clean off. And then my mom.
It's all right. That's enough. I just want to talk to Johnny. He could know more than you.
Not gonna hurt him, right? Cause he's real. He's not made up.
I'm not gonna hurt him.
Johnny used to be boy. Cause Gran liked listening to his songs. When we was picking mushrooms, Johnny said he saw a girl with ashen hair in the swamp.
Where can I find Johnny?
There's a little meadow on the edge of the swamp. This strange tree grows there. Look around, you'll see him.
Thank you.
Monkey balls. Well, that was terrible. loot. Stop fucking Jesus.
If Johnny's real, he must leave prints. Small footprint. Johnny's been through here. Lead to a burrow. Wonder what's inside.
Johnny? Don't be afraid. A Luton? Ah, a godling. Not many of you left. I'm looking for a woman with ashen hair. Seen her? Tell me everything, from the start. Where did you see her? What was she doing? It's important to me. Why not? What's wrong? Can't talk? Why? Lost your voice? Can I help you somehow? Want me to follow you? No choice, I guess. Looks like rain.
Terrible.
stay close to me. This the place? Let me look around. Something's on the ledge? Something that'll get you your voice back? Guess I gotta make this climb.
And a dragon. That before. There's a dragon in here too, which kind of sucks. I have draconid oil whatsoever. I have hybrid necro butt inspector. Pretty sure I do not like the fact that there is a dragon in nearby. That complicates matters in a way that it is easy to beat them. Oh crap. I see two! I better just spend another harpy. Pay attention! Pay attention to the thing in front of you! Also, we're gonna want Quinn for this fucker. Remember this thing at all. That's just a normal wyvern? Oh, that's what that was. That was fucking tiny! How is that a... Stop! Jesus. I'm gonna have to kill you fuckers first, aren't I? Boom, howdy go! Harpy down.
Ah!
No, don't call for help. Dear God, you annoying harpy bitch. Alright, where's that Wyvern at? I didn't do that.
Maybe he meant this bottle. Done celebrating?
My favorite words! Life without savoring the sound of surreptitious shenanigans is like licking snails through a cloth. Thank you for this, noble whoever you are. Long be your life.
Hang on a minute. I helped you, now you help me.
Would you turn this beautiful act of altruism into a banal bartering of favors?
How do you lock someone's voice in a bottle? Just wondering.
As am I, especially as mine's a voice to crown all voices. Sometimes it's like a forest brook, at others, like a roll of thunder. And let's be honest, I talk enough to fill three barrels or more.
Somebody used some powerful magic on you, as a prank or just to be mean. How'd you lose your voice?
One morning, I awoke and opened my mouth for my usual bout of singing with the thrushes. Lo and behold, no sound escaped. I tried and tried, almost burst a blood vessel. Then I went to the village, because word has it, the new cunning woman works miracles. But people began crying out, "A smudger! A smudger!" and sick their dogs on me. Do I look like a smudger to you?
Not a bit.
Well, I thought not. So it must be the crone's doing. Who else would curse me? Blackbird friend of mine located my voice, but I was helpless to retrieve it.
Couldn't ask a raven friend to just give you the bottle?
Ravens serve the crones. They don't help no one.
I'm looking for a young, ashen-haired woman. See anyone like that?
Did I ever? Remember it as if it were yesterday. Soon as I woke, I went to empty my bowels. My favorite part of the day. Defecating to the sunrise, downright glorious. Suddenly, heard a bang, so loud it couldn't have been me. And that lass appeared, out of nowhere. Young, ashen-haired, just like you said. Wounded and panting to boot. She raced off towards the children's hut. Quick as if the crones were after her. I yelled some unpleasantries. She disturbed my mourn. Sadly, I'd lost my voice, so I don't think she heard me.
I've been to the village in the swamp, met a woman who might have been a crone.
Did she seem confused to you?
Nuts, completely.
So I'm not crazy. That's no crone. That's the granny who takes care of the orphans. Claims the kids made me up. Me!
An orphanage in a swamp?
What do you have against swamps? Lived here my whole life, and I heartily recommend it.
What do you know about the crones?
They're as old as this forest. Cruel. Vindictive. Not to be crossed.
What if someone does cross them?
Might take his voice, might take his life. Depends on their whim. They're nasty. Although, they care for this land and its folk in their own way. Supposedly, they always keep their word, but you must be careful what you ask for. Won't find them until they want to be found. See them until they want to be seen. But remember, they see and hear all that happens in the mire.
She ran off toward the orphanage. Kids could know something, or the old woman who takes care of them.
Oh, that old hag don't speak to strangers, and you're a stranger.
Will she talk to you?
I have spoken to her, got my ways. So be it. You helped me, and I'm no bore. Come with me.
Eh, it's probably actually a good place to stop. No, it's not, because then we'll start doing quests, and I need to be able to look for stuff later.
It's clear, not a crone in sight. I need to sing to Gran. That ought to calm her.
Little Johnny softly gazed, fire waning pale. Pop! A spark jumped out and whispered, "Listen, I'm a tale."
You got your voice back.
I did. Though I seem to have lost an octave somewhere in the process. I shall look for it when I get home.
You're not allowed here, Johnny. You shouldn't have come.
Calm down, Gran. Don't get angry. It's not good for you.
The woman I asked about earlier.
Forgive me, Gran. But this fellow absolutely must talk to the ladies.
No. She's not allowed.
Please, it's important.
The fellow will be quiet. Gran, please hear me out. I found little Yagna when she got lost, did I not? Did I break Ginny's fever too? I did. I ask anything in return? No. Didn't even fuss about my stolen voice. Well, now I want something. Gran, help this fellow. Because otherwise he'll pester me day and night, even during potty time. His lass is missing. Perhaps the ladies can help find her, eh?
Well, since you put it that way, Johnny, I'll help him. Come with me. Johnny's a good, good lad, though the ladies don't like him. No, foul creature, they say, don't like him.
Who are the women in the tapestry?
Those are the ladies.
with power o'er all. Beseech I thee, answer my call. Before you a worm crawls, wretched and small.
Dare you disturb our rest, woman?
Is someone speaking through you?
Good looking and clever, too. Where have you been hiding, boy?
I'm looking for the woman with ashen hair. I know you met her. Where is she?
Oh, he's impatient. Perhaps he only likes ashen-haired girls.
The young woman. She's my daughter by choice. I raised her.
If she's shapely, what does it matter?
Matters to me.
I believe we've hit a nerve. He's bubbling like well-fed yeast. Oh, that's how I like him.
It's clear you met her. Tell me everything.
That was blunt. Well, perhaps it's for the best. Tell me, have you got bollocks? Do you fear woodland beasts?
Oh, hard times are upon this white-haired one. Brother has turned against brother. The land is soaked in blood. Evil reigns stronger than ever before.
A dark power has surfaced near Dunwarren. It feeds on hatred and disdain. Destroy the beast, and we may be grateful. Tell you all we know about this ashen-haired maid.
Dark power? You need a knight errant, or a witch hunter, not a witcher.
The alderman of Dunwarren will tell you all. Remember to collect payment from him after you complete your task. And now our servant will bring you the dagger.
A dagger? What for?
When the alderman sees this dagger, he'll know we sent you. He'll aid with all.
I'll talk to the alderman, but I can't promise anything.
Move, woman! Give the young man the dagger.
And you, White One, return only once you've completed the task.
Aye, mistress, right. On me way. Dagger. Gotta bring the dagger. The dagger. For you. Lady told me to give it to you. Here it is. The dagger. Place the alderman's payment on the stone. Stone bear. Stone shear. Stone nose. Stone ears.
There was a wicked witch living in the moss. Had a house.
There, that's good. That's a much better place to stop, because I can freely go and get ingredients later for potions and stuff that I need to get. Goodbye, and see y'all next time.